Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus, sitting at 29 wins. You know, nothing big, nothing major, it's just 29 wins in a row. Who really knows exactly how it's going to go, except, well, I guess whatever force you believe in. You see, Day, it's going to be Quebec Papa Tango 3 Echo Papa Delta 0. We've got the Black Powder and Monster Manuel, along with pretty awful stats all the way around. Yeah, this is not really what I would say is a good start. Oh, look at that, we actually did get a, we got a level 2 cube of meat out of the Monster Manuel. Really? I didn't know that was even possible. I'm still trying to wrestle with myself and being able to actually handle the corn flies, obviously, as you can see right here. Ooh, I'm gonna take petrified poop, which is great. So yeah, this starts out very good. The only benefit is that, of course, we do have Black Powder, and if we end up being able to use it effectively, to be quite honest, I'll be slightly amazed. Petrified Poop, of course, is going to increase the amount of chance that we get something useful out of our poop piles, let it be hearts, coins, etc., etc. Meat Boy, I already miss you, and it also Curse the Lost, by the way. So basically what the Black Powder is you can look at that trailing gunpowder trail behind Isaac, and if you draw a circle, it will create a satanic ring, which will deal damage to anything that's stuck inside of the ring. And if it actually kills something inside of that ring, it has a very high chance at dropping a black soul heart, which, as you can imagine, is probably pretty useful, especially in our current predicament here. I don't think there's any reason not to take pills, to be quite honest. Lemon Party, that would have been a good one to use on the boss. I'm going to use this Empress card as well to take on the boss, whoever that's going to be. And Monster Manual, of course, the only good thing about that is that it does have it's a book, so it gets us one step closer to Bookworm. But whenever you're working with a start like this, you need to take advantage of any single advantage that you can get a hold of. I mean, right now, the only advantage is the fact that, well, we've got Petrified Poop. I mean, this is the thing about Black Powder. It can be okay. Kind of like that. We got really lucky there that I didn't get collapsed on. Almost ran into that by the shamblers, or whatever they're called. Like, to be quite honest, I mean, this isn't going to come to a surprise to anyone, but I don't really know the names of a lot of the mobs in the game. I'm sort of like Josh in that aspect, and I mean that endearingly. I don't mean that in a derogatory sense. You know, it's I have my names for the mobs. He has his names for, like, you know, the items and stuff. I mean, hell, there's even a Josh mod out there that he made, by the way. Which is quite hilarious in and of itself. But I just, like, I've always called these guys, for example, Shy Guys. I'm not exactly sure what they're called. The hosts, I believe the hosts are actually correct. The shamblers, I have no idea what they're called. The gluttony mobs, the ones that sort of, like, open up their chest and then split out the brimstone shot at you. Those are actually called this, or V's, or Vi's, or however you want to pronounce it. Thank you very much. Ooh, I will take that Eternal Heart. I am going to use the key here, and Box of Friends is very interesting. It would be a lot better than if we had Monster Manual, that's for sure. If you're wondering what I'm looking for right now, I'm just looking for our item room, that's really it. This Empress card is going to be exceedingly helpful against the boss. Thank you very much. Fires, I appreciate that. And again, I want to thank everybody for the birthday wishes as well. I know that we did not have an Isaac video on Monday. That was the result of me just trying to get caught up. Because if you... it's impossible. I really do truly feel that it's impossible for me to take a mental vacation, even though, like, I probably need one from work. Not that this is, like, a stressful job or anything like that. It's just there is a lot of busy work whenever it's involved here. I don't like Little Haunt. I'm going to forego us getting the Box of Friends here for something better than Little Haunt or freaking... The thing about Dr. Fetus, I'm going to take it, but I do it under sort of duress here. The thing about Dr. Fetus, and I talked about this the last time that we saw Dr. Fetus, is that I do feel that Dr. Fetus is sort of not great now. Unless if you can get Pyromaniac, or you can somehow get, the host hat or something like that. Don't get me wrong, I like Dr. Fetus. I think that, you know, it's on a run like this, it's probably not that essential. But at the same time, though, I'm really worried about our survivability here. So, by the way, Dr. Fius gave obviously turns all of our tears into bombs, which can be good or bad, depending on how you look at it. Usually in the past, I would have been just through the freaking roof that we got Dr. Fetus. Now, not so much. It's mostly due to the fact that it is sort of detrimental to your health. If you're not, if you either don't have the damage or if you don't have the... probably didn't need to use the Emperor's card there. But yeah, if you don't have the damage, if you don't have the movement speed, Dr. Fetus can actually be sort of dangerous. It's almost like Ipecac in that sense. In fact, I would even go so far as to rank Dr. Fetus below Ipecac right now. We're going to get HP, that's fine. We're going to get another HP from the Eternal Heart. So we're leaving the first floor with Dr. Fetus, Small Rock, which was a nice little benefit to our damage. Not so much to our movement speed, of course, but, you know, we're coming away with a decent amount of HP here. Of course, Curse of the Blind on floor 2 is just about as trolly as the game can ever get, outside of giving you, like, you know, a Krampus fight in floor 2, which I'm sure is going to happen eventually, maybe one day, probably. But Dr. Fetus, again, it is one of my favorite items. I get less... The more that I use it, the less jazzed I am about seeing it. Because I know that it comes out with more and more inherent risks every time we get a new update or, like, new items and stuff. One thing I will say is that I don't know how well Dr. Fetus would work with fast bombs. Thankfully, we don't have anything. But obviously, Dr. Fetus is great with Mr. Mega. Great with sad bombs, of course, is the dream. Poison bombs is great. I wouldn't really necessarily say that it's so good to have whenever you've got Bobby bombs or homing bombs. You'd be surprised at that not being all that good. So, if you ask me right now, would we actually re-roll this run? I would say yes. I would probably be 100% fine with that, even though we have Dr. Fetus. And I realize that this is going to seem like I'm taking a crazy pill here. I don't know what a crazy pill would be, but it sounds like something Ozzy Osbourne would write about. Yeah, I mean, I don't really want the Mega Bean. It's like Dr. Fetus scares me, not because of the item necessarily, but it's because I know that we don't have the movement speed to really deal with it right now, and I don't trust myself with Dr. Fetus. It's not you thing. No, it's not, oh my goodness. Well, I would love to be able to get over there. Unfortunately, we can't fly. But that is definitely a goal with that library, because obviously, I mean, let's not beat around the bush. Probably one of those books is going to be either the Book of Revelations or the Satanic Bible, which would be exceedingly helpful right now. So I'm just going to go straight down the middle here, and we get Book of Revelations. Hey, look at that. Lucky us, huh? And I would absolutely love to have an orbital here with this build. So I guess we say thank you to Monster Manuel, I suppose. I mean, it didn't really do much for us, but, you know, hey, it was there. It's sort of like Jesse when we're playing Heroes of Storm. He's like, you know, he was there. He wasn't really doing anything of you. That's just mean. That's not true at all. Jesse has saved me many times in our Heroes of the Storm games. Not as much as I saved him, mind you, but yeah, I mean, Jesse's sort of been helpful. Our movement speed really worries me right now. It would be unfortunate if we ended up not being able to get into the rest of those books. It wouldn't be the end of the world, it would just be unfortunate. So let's go see who we've got here. It's going to be Famine. We pretty much knew that was going to happen because, well, we used the Book of Revelations. Champion Famine, the only thing I can say to that is that I thought that I'd be able to get around that rock. Turns out, no. Our 0.70 movement speed said no thank you, so... We get that. Obviously, we're going to take both of these devil deals, regardless of what they are. We can't tell what they are because it's Curse of the Blind, but you know what I mean. Goathead would be awesome. If we could actually get Brimstone, that'd be great, too. We get the Virus, which is an item that exists in the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. Multidimensional Baby and Little Brimstone. Well, gonna be honest, pretty bummed out about that. We're gonna head on down to the next floor here. Pretty awful. Like, I probably would have taken Little Brimmy just because. And, let me make sure that this is... The capture looks off for some reason a little bit here. There we go. I think that's a little bit better. It may not have changed on OBS anyway. But yeah, I probably, like, would not have taken Multidimensional Baby over Little Brimstone. I sort of wish that I would have taken the two-heart deal with the devil first before taking the one-heart deal. But that being said, of course, I knowing myself, I would have taken them both regardless, just because of the fact that, like, you know, it's Curse the Blind. You don't really know what you're going to get. Now, this Forget Me Now is showing up at a really bad time if it wants us to use him. To use it? Use him? I don't know. I'm pretty sure there's no gender assigned to Forget Me Now. Either way, you're not going to be able to convince me that we need to get rid of the Book of Revelations. Not right now. The only way that I would even consider using Forget Me Now in this spot is if we ended up being in this situation that we're in right now, but we had 12 HP. That's the only time I would consider it, because at least we could get a second chance of getting a decent deal with the devil instead of the one that we got. Now, you might be wondering how come I'm not really so jazzed about us having Little Brimstone. That is mostly due to the fact that we'll never be able to use him effectively because we have Dr. Fetus. Example, if I try to sit here and charge Little Brimstone, as you see, we run the risk of that, of every Dr. Fetus user's nightmare, which is that the bombs will hit themselves. I mean, thankfully our shot speed and our tier speed is not quite that high, but I'll be constantly shooting out bombs, which is extremely hazardous to my health. And I'm not really down with that. Anything that isn't that anything that's not very hazardous to my health, I'm more than happy to take that route. For some reason I thought Little Brimstone could actually crack those open. Apparently I was mistaken. Apparently I don't know what I'm talking about. Apparently this comes as no shock to anybody, including myself. Oh man. What a weekend. What a weekend. I've got so much work to catch up on. I wish that I could enjoy days off. You know, especially after how crazy, you know, how crazy fun the birthday weekend was. Even yesterday, with it being my, I say yesterday, but it was actually technically day before yesterday when this video will come out. It's on Monday, all right, on May 1st. You know, even though that was my birthday, I still could not help myself from doing at least, you know, a little bit of work, because I hate not seeing a video go up on the channel. I don't know. I didn't really have time to do a backlog due to the hard drive failing on me. My original intent was going to have a backlog, so where I could have at least been able to, you know, I would at least be able to have some sort of content here on YouTube without there being sort of a lapse of content, because of the birthday stuff going on. But again, with my main hard drive dying, or at least it didn't die. It didn't flat out die, but it was failing. It would have died. There's absolutely no way I would have been able to do a 24-hour stream or two 12-hour streams on that hard drive. It would have absolutely bit the dust before the stream even ended. I'd be lucky to have gotten 5 more hours out of that hard drive, maybe. And you really don't want to mess with a hard drive that you know is failing. You're putting everything on that drive at risk. And even though, you know, a lot of people will say, oh yeah, I'll take Mini Mush. Even though a lot of people will say, well, you know, if you're going to replace a hard drive anyway, then who cares about the data? Just back it up with like Carbonite or something and you're all Gucci. That is true. But another thing you have to remember, this is something I used to tell, my customers whenever I was doing IT stuff all the time, is that you never, ever, 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 in my opinion, you never ever want to leave yourself no options if you truly might need a backup of the data that you have a backup for. The more redundancies that you can have in data backups, the better. And there's absolutely no reason, in my opinion anyway, there's no reason for me to put the data that I know that I still will probably need at risk on that drive just by simply using it. I'm going to go all the way back here. This is going to take a while, but I mean, boss rush is just not happening anyway. I'm going to use the Yara rune inside of the boss trap room. Oh yeah, I forgot we had that. I forgot we had Tiny Planet. So first off, I'm going to go take a void rune, and I'm going to void Tiny Planet and hopefully get movement speed, because Lord knows that's exactly what we need. And secondly, I'm going to go back. I'll take the Yara rune, and I'll double the chests inside of the boss trap room. And I almost took that. Alright, so we got damage. We did not get speed, unfortunately, but... no, whatever. We'll be alright. Had to lean over and make sure that my phone was muted. Alright. So we'll take the Yarrow Rune. Now, why do I care so much about doing this with the Yarrow Rune inside of the boss trap room? Well, and mob trap room. It's because if we do actually have two or maybe even just one item in one of those golden chests, it's possible that we can make ourselves even more items out of there as well, depending on if one of the source chests had an item in there to start with, which is what I'm really going for right now. Got that. We're gonna get full HP here, and that probably is worth us doing another round on this floor with the forget me now. So I'm gonna Yara. We have exactly 8 keys, which is perfect. I'm only gonna open one, and then we're gonna fight, and then we'll open up the rest of them. So I can't move up. There we go. So what are we looking for here? We're looking for hopefully one of these chests. We know that the bottom right chest didn't have any items in it. We're hoping that maybe one of the other items or other chests have an item in there. I hope. We did get keys, so we're going to profit keys here no matter what, which is great. Basically got all of our keys back anyway. That is a analogous rune, blank rune. Well, it turned out to be an analogous rune. Those are not items, but it's a lot of HP. And alright, so there was no actual items in the chests, which is okay. I'm not going to be too salty about that. We end up getting a lot of resources out of there as well. We're going to take Forget Me Now and see if we can get another go here with the Deal with the Devil. Again, some people may see this as I don't really need to with the amount of HP we have in Dr. Fetus, but that's in and of itself. That's beside. I mean, that's really the point that I'm trying to make here. Of course, we would get Curse of the Mind. Is that I wanted to. I want to make sure that we shore up our defenses here. Really, I don't need to deal with the devil here. If we could just get movement speed, I'd be happy. I don't really care too much about a deal with the devil in this spot. There's gonna be Hagalas looking for movement speed. It's pretty fly. Gets our third orbital, and I'm fine with that. Well, that makes you small. Not too big on that. No pun intended there. No irony intended there. Another pretty fly doesn't matter. Just looking for movement speed. But with that said, we have an excellent start now. We have enough HP for me to feel comfortable using Dr. Fetus pretty aggressively. That doesn't mean that I'm going to try to throw away, but every time we get a damage up, this is going to increase the amount of damage that our bombs do, which therein lies makes it... which in turn makes our... you know, makes this a lot easier for us. So we get Dad's Key, which is something, and of course we get the golden chest that have items in there. I'm not gonna take either one of these till after we're done with this fight. Dad's Key is gonna just basically be a local door opener, including secret doors. But you cannot get yourself out of a boss trap or mob trap room, but you can get into them regardless of your HP. So get a little baggy and rune bag. Alright. Well, that was Horf, which is just an Ipecac shot. How do I feel about us getting a little baggy? I'm not happy about it, to be quite honest, because it's an item that I hate. And why would I hate that? Basically, it turns all tarot card and rune drops into pills, meaning that rune bag is basically completely worthless. And we're just going to reroll our entire run. Now we have the Guillotine, Dogtooth, Tech 1, RoboBaby 2.0, Lard, Spilt Milk... Fate's Reward. If I didn't say Dogtooth, I'd said it now. Dogtooth. Yeah. 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 Wasn't the best. Not the best reroll. I absolutely hate Guillotine, just so everyone's clear on this. I really dislike it. It would have been nice if we got something a little bit better. We did get some Red Heart HP, which I'm happy about, because that makes our Deal with the Devil a little bit cheaper. And we have no idea what this is, obviously, so I'm just going to pick it up. We get Red Candle! Hey, you know what? I'm fine with that. Going to go ahead and bomb this, see if we can get something else. Got the Ladder, which is about as useless as it gets. And more options. Alright, well, unfortunately we did lose Humbling Bundle. Was the reroll worth it? No. I wouldn't say so. I will say this, Red Candle is definitely worth it. Because that will reduce the amount of micromanagement that I have to do on the, on moving. And you wouldn't think that moving is such a big deal here. It's like, why do you care about moving, Sinvicta? Well, it's because the guillotine offsets where I normally see Isaac's head. That's not exactly where Isaac is. If you look very closely here, look for the ring of the pretty flies. That's actually where Isaac is. It's almost like it's in a weird way, it's almost as bad as Isaac's heart. Not quite as bad, because I don't want to make, you know, I don't want to get that sensational about it, but it is pretty bad. Bob's Rotten Head, which is not going to help us out. Alright. So we got a little bit of help here for as far as our money is concerned. Would I reroll this again? Absolutely. I don't even think that's a rhetorical question. Yeah, so the problem that I always have with the guillotine is that I always just... It's hard to keep track of where your hitbox is. And that's really it. I mean, it does come with a damage up, which is kind of nice, but in my opinion, it's not worth it. I should also mention that Isaac's actual head, does turn into an orbital. I also just noticed that we have the host hat as well, which is a very funny game. Very, very funny. Remember that time that we had Dr. Fetus? See, it feels like forever and a day ago. There's a lot of bombs in here. Alright, we did not get a deal with the devil. We got rotten meat, which is... What did we take damage from? I don't quite know. Anyway. So we just get a plain old HP up. This run is, like, sort of not good. Even after the reroll, like, we didn't really have anything to lose that was necessarily all that great, except maybe Humbling Bundle. I'm glad that we don't have to worry about Little Baggy anymore. Because that is sort of a detriment, in my opinion. But one thing I'm not happy about is, obviously, the guillotine, and also the fact that we didn't really gain any stats. Like, we gained a little bit of tears rate, I suppose. But we lost damage, which I'm not a fan of. And we also lost the ability to have Dr. Freakin' Fetus. But, that's why they call him rerolling. Because you never know what you're going to get. What am I doing? What was that bomb even meant to do? I am going to go into the vault. I don't really care about the chest, to be honest. Wow. I am stunned that we did not take damage from that. That was a point blank. Oh, you know why we didn't take damage? Because we have the host hat. You freaking goofus? I was going to say goofus, but... Sounds a little bad. I don't know what a goofus is. A goofus sounds like something that Krendor would buy in IKEA. Tonsillitis. Don't really care about it. Also, are we not producing flies with our tears? I see that we have one. You know what? I'm not going to take Satanic Bible. As crazy as that might seem, I'm not going to take it because I actually think that Red Candle helps us more. The less we have to shoot, the better off we'll be. I am still going to go to the store, however. Of course, the maze ever lets me do anything. Like, those flies that we created, they didn't come from our tears. They came from Red Candle. So I'm very confused as to where these are... Why we're not producing any flies. So we got a massive tears up from taking damage that's from spilt milk. Which is pretty good. I mean, our DPS is quite good whenever we have a faster tears rate with this build. BBF, I don't really care about it. Oh my god, I hate the guillotine so much. I mean, BBF is good, don't get me wrong. And yes, I know that we would have a lot of good excuses here for followers, but I'm banking on a reroll at this point. I'm hoping that we can get a reroll. That would give us Bookworm. I'm going to see what this is. It's going to be 2 of diamonds. Awesome. I'm just going to use it right now. Not really interested in Mom's Purse. Trinket Smelter, we could buy, but... We get the treasure map, which is fine, I suppose. I mean, this will help us navigate with the compass now, so... Yeah. Oh, yeah. So this is sort of why, right here, that I said I would rather have the red candle. The red candle, I mean, red candle's damage is fantastic. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. We're gonna get magic much, which is also gonna help us out quite a bit. We get Little Delirium and Succubus. I'm not gonna take Little Delirium. If I had taken BBF, I would have considered it, but eh. And why not take Little Delirium? I just don't trust... I'm going to be completely honest, I just don't trust the fact of, that it could turn into Bob's brain. That would be a terrible way to go. Did we curse the maze again? Oh my god. So obviously Magic Mush gives us an all stats up and a damage multiplier. One of the best, most premier items in the game, period. I don't know what most premier means, it just sounds smart. What's nice about this little secret room over here is that we can bomb our way and save a lot of time on this floor. There's no reason to bomb the mushrooms in my... What am I doing? There's no reason to bomb the mushrooms, in my opinion, because we've already got Magic Mush. And we had already seen Mini Mush, so there's really no point. I mean, this floor is just going to fly by. I do still feel a little bit crazy that I did not stick with the Satanic Bible. That may have been a oversight on my part. I don't know. I guess it remains to be seen. I feel that it was not a bad choice, because Red Candle is quite good. And it sort of shores up our offense here, because we don't have any defense. I mean, we have... That's not true. We actually have quite a bit of defense. We have three orbitals. One of them being Guillotine. I'm going to take Holy Shot here. Now, Holy Shot is not going to directly help us with Tech 1. However, it will help us with Fate's Reward. Yeah, that's probably worth it. Okay, so we got a Joker card out of that. I will come back for the Sun card if I have to. It's only a Sun card. It's not that big of a deal. And that we already have a mapping anyway, so there's no reason for it. Unless we need to heal. Oh my god. Yeah, so again, you're seeing the navigational issues here with Isaac, thanks to Guillotine. It's actually a great bomb. It's a lucky bomb. It's not like I meant that to kill Mom's hand, but hey, you know what? Sometimes you just look good, sometimes you don't. I usually don't. Starter deck. I mean, starter deck is, you know, is going to help us hold on to the Sun card if I really truly wanted it, which I don't care about. And we get a little Gish. There's the Holy Shot that you saw there from Fate's Reward. What is going on with Isaac's head? Is it me or is his head like... It's like colliding with something. I'm not sure what. Look at it, like that right there, like snaps backwards. It's very odd. So we get a little Gish, meaning that I probably should have taken BBF even more. And we have this whole song and dance routine again. So we did not get a deal with the devil. Let's see what this is. Sun card. Hey, you know what? That's going to heal us back up at least. Obviously, I'm not going to be taking Plan C. With us not having any HP, or extra lives, I should say. Really no point. We got Speedball, which I absolutely will take. And that puts us one more closer to Spun. Hangman, I'm just going to go ahead and use that. What is this? Magician card. Go ahead and use that. I think we can afford to go pretty hard on this Demon Judgment. If you ever get a tarot card from a Demon Judgment, always check to see, especially if you have Red Heart Containers, always check to see what the card is. It's going to cost a little bit of extra time, but you'll be happy that you did, especially if you get a Lover's card or something like that, and you have a lot of Red Heart Containers. We get Experimental Treatment, which I will take. It's going to give us Spun. We lost so much tears We gained a lot of damage, though, but wow. We lost a metric poop ton of tears. Wow. Our tears rate went up by 7. And I didn't notice if we actually had gained or lost HP. We actually gained HP, I think. Sorry, give me one second here. I've been getting very weird audio issues cropping up since I redid the OS. We got Crystal Lost again, hooray. For some odd reason, I don't know why, but for some odd reason, my mic is like, it changes its... I think it's because it's trying to fight with my webcam mic, which I don't use, obviously. Oh, Chubb. Oh, that was the wrong time for Chubb to get a little gished there. But anyway, the microphone that I use right now, which is just a regular old Blue Yeti microphone, I guess it sometimes fights with the webcam mic. So I just disabled it because I'm seeing blips popping up here on the encoder. And I'm curious, I actually hope that the audio is going to be okay for this recording. I'm going to check it afterwards, obviously. If you're watching this on YouTube, that means that it wasn't that bad. The tower. I got a bomb and a key. That's right. I remember that we had the ladder. Don't worry. So our damage is actually not that bad now, thanks to experimental treatment. It's just that our tears rate got completely destroyed by experimental treatment. But I feel like we probably got some help there from Magic Mush, more so than experimental treatment. We probably gained a mild damage upgrade that got multiplied by Magic Mush itself. I don't know which. I guess one of the demon fires shot us. It's hard to tell, really, with Guillotine. Alright, we have a golden bomb here. I probably should have, like, picked up the golden bomb before doing that. We are going to get Fate, which is going to give us flying, which is exceedingly helpful in this spot. Mostly because of the fact that, well... I hate to keep beating a dead horse, but we have the Guillotine. Anything that makes controlling Isaac more difficult is something that I'm not usually down with. We got a lot of time here. We're not going to worry about going to do boss rush. Boss rush is already over anyway. Of course, we don't care about Hush either. It's a very odd room. So Fate, by the way, gives us flying and an eternal heart. We pretty much have to do this. Whenever I see 3 red chests, that's an automatic. We just do it, in my opinion. Gonna use the hermit card here. We get Black Candle. Oh, thank you, Black Candle, my old friend. Hello, Black Candle, my old friend. There's too many syllables in that. I don't think Disturbed would have been able to do a good cover of it if it was Hello, Black Candle, my old friend. Which is not even the name of the actual song, but, you know. Alright, so Black Candle is going to make it to where we don't have to worry about curses anymore. Very happy about that. Oh my god, why are we moving so fast? Go ahead and grab these here. We're going to head on over to the item room. And if we can get some more money, I would love to start putting some back inside of the donation machine. Hey, greed. Fine with me. More money, we don't care about the tick. More chests. So I've been noticing we've been getting a lot of chest spawning lately. It looks like we actually have Guppy's tail, but we really, obviously we don't. Not completely fine with it. I shot my red candle there. So, I guess depression. I suppose. I mean, we already have one holy light effect. Might as well get another one. I don't care about that bomb. I am going to go check the arcade really fast. Ooh. Black rune. So the black rune will be nice. If we end up having to hold on to it till like the chest or something, then, you know, we can get some pretty good value out of it. For the most part, it's sort of doesn't really matter that we have it. I mean, again, with this being the final time that we get any sort of benefit out of more options, unless we find the Bloody Crown, it's not gonna be that big of a deal. Let's go put some money back in our donation machine. Our donation machine single-handedly saved us in that last run, and I think it's time that we pay a little bit more love and attention to it. There we go. All right. So let's go fight Mom. Mom really shouldn't be all that bad. I wish I could get, like, I don't wish. I should get more practice with Guillotine. It really shouldn't be an item that I'm scared of. And it's not necessarily that I'm scared of it. It's just that, like, I just don't like it. It's so against the... Don't do this to me. It's so against the norm that I don't want to deal with it, is the thing. And we get Void, which... I don't think Void actually does anything with candles. I know it doesn't give us a stat up, and I don't think we got the effect out of it. Unless if it just shot a tear. I'm honestly not quite sure what happened. Alright, so Void, best space bar item in the game, in my opinion. Everyone knows it, but if you don't, basically what it will do is it will take any space bar pedestal item that you see, and it will turn it, it will add the effect, the on-use active effect to itself. So for example, if you voided Bob's Rotten Head, you'd be able to, every six rooms, or every full charge that you get with Void, you'd be able to throw out a Bob's Rotten Head, and then you could also combine that with, like, say, the Book of Revelations, or, you know, Anarchist Cookbook, or whatever have you. Which is good. It basically turns into whatever kind of spacebar item you want. And it was one of the best, if not the best thing that to come out of Afterbirth Plus when it initially released. It seems like so long ago. Two of spades, doubles our keys, two of hearts. Don't really care about that. Spades. Tower card, might as well. I will take Liberty Cap. Just so we can get a little bit of extra damage, just in case. So if we come across a passive item that we don't want, any passive item that is obviously not an active item, or a spacebar item, will turn into a random stat upgrade every time you use Void, which is very neat. I feel like our damage is just really bad in this fight for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe it's our 16-tier delay that's making it seem pretty bad. Alright, we did get a deal with the devil. We may Void that. Gonna be duality, hooray. Gonna be honest, I didn't see that fire there. I'm actually gonna take it for the tiers up. It basically doubled our tiers rate. Our tier delay, rather, or made it divide it in half. Look, it doesn't matter. All I know is that a faster tier's fire rate would be nice. And that's exactly what we got out of it. It allows us to deal damage a lot faster, allows us to be a lot safer. Oh yeah, I can't get in there. And I normally would have voided the screw there, but our tier delay was so bad. It was at 16 before. Now we're back to where we started on this run. And this is way better. So are we going to win this run? Yeah, probably. I mean, let's not try to be coy here. We're probably going to win this run. It took a little bit longer than I probably would have imagined, but that's mostly just due to my ineptitude with Guillotine. I'm actually going to take Blank Card. I'm not going to take Void. I am going to Void, and we got damage, and we also got Shot Speed, which doesn't really matter for us. So Blank Card, of course, will assimilate to whatever card we're currently holding on to, which in this case is the Black Rune. Runes also count as cards, by the way. It's very good. You see me do those game-breaking Yara rune runs. So we essentially have a better Void without having the active item benefits of having the Void item. Which can be pretty good. I like being able to give some sort of value to items that normally would not have any value. Like, for example, a Void whenever we don't need it anymore. Wow, that was a an amazing pursuit there by that Diglett. At this point, I don't think it's worth it for me to even consider going into the cursed room. How is this brimstone spider still alive? I don't feel that it's worth it. I will go see what's inside of the super secret room, though. That howling that you hear, by the way, that is, that's Dog's Tooth trying to tell me that, hey, there's something over here. It will also, it'll also show you where there is a crawl space if you happen to be in a room with one. Well, it won't show you, but it will do a different sound for a crawl space, put it that way. So we got a hermit card, which is going to be our free teleport out of anywhere that we don't want to be. Now, what's nice about the tears up that we got out of the screw is that we can combine that with spilt milk. So if we do happen to get hit, we're going to have a very, very nice amount of DPS boosted. Because spilt milk will basically essentially double our tears rate again. And you can get below the, you can get out of the tears cap with spilt milk. It's one of the few items in the game that can do so. Hoping that little Gish would help us out a little bit more than that. There we go. Very easy. No, no deal with the devil. No problem. We don't need no stinking deal with the devil, Stanley. We've got it all right here. Alright, there's another dice room. Would I re-roll this run? Yeah, I'd re-roll it. Would I be upset if we got Isaac's heart and ended up losing the streak? Yeah, I'd be upset. But that's the risk you got to be willing to take. If you can't handle the swings, then you best get off the playground, baby. I don't know what that means. So that was supposed to be a poker term that turned into a halfway Dave Chappelle skit. I wish I was like even a fraction of an inch funny as Dave Chappelle, who, again, here we go in the stand-up comedian discussion again. I believe that Dave Chappelle is the current funniest living stand-up artist. He ranks number two all time for me anyway, with number one being George Carlin. As far as like living stand-up comedians right now, Dave Chappelle is second to none. Number two would probably be Eddie Izzard. Number three would definitely be Louis C.K. I haven't been able to catch either of their specials yet. Okay, so this is a global D4. Sinus infection and unicorn really don't help us. I'm going to re-roll this with the four room. Get Celtic Cross and the Omega Penny. Crooked Penny. Yep. All right. Well, we kept the boy. We kept the black room. So the crooked penny. Basically, what it does is it will either double everything in the room, like a Yara rune. What just hit us? I don't know what hit us up here. It will either double everything in the room, like a Yara rune, including item pedestals, or it will consume everything, give you no benefit, and give you one penny, which is exactly right there. So we're 0 for 1 right now. Is what I'm trying to say. Thanks to the crooked penny. Sort of confused as to where Isaac's body actually is right now. It's very difficult to see it. Now I know what you're saying. You're saying, Sinvictor, are you going to use the crooked penny in the chest? I will if like the items are terrible and I don't think that we're going to get much benefit out of the black rune. Let's put it that way. I shouldn't, but we're just being silly now at this point. So yeah, this is... If we... I sort of contemplated actually taking a hit here, deliberately, on Isaac to get our tears rate up a little bit thanks to spilled milk, but... That's just me being lazy. If we had any more HP though, I definitely would have done that. Cause that fight wouldn't have even been nearly that long if we had an uncapped tears rate. All right, so here we go. Let's find out what's inside of our chest. We've got Friend Zone, Toxic Shock, Kamikaze, and Daddy Longlegs. You know what? Why not? All right. Well, that worked out very beautifully. I don't think we can get double daddy long legs, so you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to be crazy and just void everything. Let's see our stats. Watch our stats on the left. Yeah, that was pretty good. We can use Hermit card, see if we can get closer to Blue Baby. That did not work out at all. Now, obviously, Daddy Long Legs is the premier item that we saw right there. And this is what Tech 1 looks like with a tier delay of 2. Also, I don't know what's going on with Isaac's head right now. We've taken way too much damage in this run, or this floor. But Tech 1 apparently turns into Tech 2 whenever you have a 2-tier delay. And even with a 4-tier delay, this is pretty darn good, I'm not going to lie. Dog's Tooth tells us that there's a secret room here. How did we know that? Well, I can see the secret room on the map. So yeah, I think that voiding those 8 items worked out very well. If I do say so myself. That said, I wouldn't recommend doing that. If you actually needed... Like, I know that we didn't need this chest at all to win. I mean, our damage, like our DPS is fantastic right now. And you already saw what it could do with a 2-tier delay. So we're in a good spot. I mean, it ended up being an enjoyable run. I will say that. I'll say that the guillotine, while being annoying, wasn't nearly as detrimental as I was like sort of dreading it would be. And we ended up having a very fun run at the end, thanks to the void rune. So you know what? It was all worth it. Double bum friend, sure, why the heck not? Why the heck not? It's a new year. I'm 1 year older. I'm 69 going on 70. I'm going to even hit myself here just for funsies. So thank you for watching, everybody. A little bit of a longer run, but a very fun run at the end. And yeah, you know what? Shout out to the guillotine. You weren't as bad. I still think you're terrible, but you made it. You didn't make it unbearable. So thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it, everyone. If you enjoy the Isaac series, please continue to support it by giving it a like, giving it a favorite, thumbsing up, dropping a comment, all that kind of good stuff. It goes a long way with letting me know what series you like and which series you don't like. And as always, I will see you all in the next episode. Until then, so long, everybody!